Lesson 10. This lesson I'm going to be talking about another chord that is very important on the guitar, and it's called G7 chord. The G7 chord, you can see on the guitar book, is string 1, 5, and 6. This chord you're going to be playing from your first one, then the last string to the first string, if you want to strum your chord. On the chord, you are going to use finger 1 for string 1, finger 2 for string 5, and finger 3 for string 6. Then you strike from string 6. Now that is, you're seeing on the diagram, you can now, let's see it on the guitar practically. You see? So you play string 1, finger 1, fret 1, you press it down. Now you use the tip of your finger. Then string 5, you use finger 2 on the fret 2. Then string 6, you use finger 3 on fret 3. That is G7th chord. Then you strike from string 6 down. I said, don't strum the chord when you are practicing the chord for the first time, any chord whatsoever. Try to play it arpeggio. Don't strum. If you strum, you not get the best of the chord, and you will not be sure if it is clean or not. If you play it one after the other, you know that you're playing it rightly. That's G7th chord. Don't forget the other former ones that we've done. This is the third chord now. The first one is C major. You are striking that from 5. Then F chord from 4. Then G7 from 6. So I'll combine the 3. That's 2 times. The chord very well. The time spent on the YouTube is not as important as the time you spend on your guitar to practice the C chord. These three chords will take you so much time to practice them and know them very well. So please don't forget to subscribe to the channel for more chords and more lessons on the guitar, and see you next time.